How much is the Big Win Foundation bringing to Nigeria to help in this direction?
So, in terms of what are we doing, I think there's a lot that we have done in different platforms, different capacities to help improve the situation, the problems that we've identified in terms of Nigeria, working with different stakeholders, while in government, but also outside government. Right now, we're involved in not as Big Win, but as Tewkesbury Foundation in collaboration with the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation, working in 6 states, working with community leaders to organize them, mobilize them to increase demand for important services, which included nutrition, immunization, and basic health services. That's an important undertaking that we're doing in collaboration with the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation in Sokoto, Kano, Kaduna, Bauchi, Yobe, and Borno. I chair the board of that organization, but there are lots of capable hands in this country through the Private Sector Health Alliance and many other groups, both in Abuja as well as in many other parts of the country, that are working with state governments outside government, but really contributing from the civil society space. So it's not just, well, the government has to do what it needs to do, but we're finding other ways to support, but that support has to only happen when there is the other hand on the side, meaning that the leadership on that other side and the partner on the other side that you can work with. And we're lucky we have some partners that have indicated interest and we're working with them. But you cannot force yourself to work where your effort is not needed. In some places, the national leaders have actually asked us to come and sit with them and say, this is what we're worrying and this is what we need you to help. So when you are not asked, it's very difficult to impose your will. But we do support through various platforms some of the work that is going on in Nigeria.
Okay, now let me quote you from the lecture that you delivered at the University of Medical Sciences in Ondo State. And you said, the future of Nigeria and its population's health is bright. But that future cannot be taken for granted. Bold, visionary leadership is required to realize that future through the path of universal access to quality, effective, efficient primary healthcare services as foundation for a people-centered healthcare system. Now, we have the private sector in terms of, you know, healthcare services. It's large, but, you know, fragmented. The public health sector is not delivering appropriately. How best can we achieve this people-centered healthcare system that we desire?
So it's really building a healthcare system with the people's needs in mind and with their voice. The priorities that we invest in are the front lines for mothers to have the care that they need, but also for them to understand what they need to do in order to be healthy for them and their children. Responding to evolving issues of non-communicable diseases, ensuring that those are also priorities, cancers, hypertension, diabetes. Allocating the resources, but also ensuring there's accountability. Engaging communities. Community engagement is one of the reasons Nigeria succeeded in polio and has come back on the track to improve routine immunization, because we engage communities through leaders that they trusted. Now, that is part of that. We don't impose, and I think it would be a mistake to think that just building big hospitals or bringing technologies by themselves will solve Nigeria's problem. Sometimes experts make the mistake that they know what is best for communities, but you need to be able to listen to them as well. And that has to do with what happens at the local level and what happens at the community level. It has to do not only with the technical elements of health, but also with the politics of health and how it's managed in the front lines. It has to do with other things in terms of governance, whether governments release money for health, whether state governments provide the money when it's needed, and whether some of that money actually finds its way to the wrong channels. Those are all needed to have a people-centered. At the end of the day, the Nigerian government, the Nigerian state exists because of the people of Nigeria, not the other way. So the principals are the people, are the youth, are the women, and every kobo that we earn from crude oil sales or whatever it is, it's because the people of this country has mandated the government to act on their behalf. Sometimes we miss that, and politicians and leaders sometimes tend to think that they are the masters and the people are actually subservient to them. But that's not the case. we should really rethink that relationship. And people-centered health system is really putting people at the front and the leaders as the servants, not the other way. When you look at not only health, again, like I said earlier, the wider dysfunctions, both politically, economically, educationally, health-wise, and security-wise, you look at this recurring theme that we seem to have gotten the chain of governance in reverse. And maybe it's the constitution and how it's framed. Maybe it's the worldview of the political leaders sometimes that actually gets them to think that they are actually the masters. But we need to reverse that. And that reversal is important for improving health. It's also going to be vital for improving education, for improving our economy. It's going to be what will lead to the promise of a brighter future for this country. If we don't do that, we will continue to totter along, not making progress and maybe not collapsing. And the promise that Nigeria has, which many of us believe in, both within and also the tremendous diaspora that we have outside, believe that this country can be great. But we feel shortchanged in terms of the gap between that expectation for that future and where this country is at today. When you see other countries like Ethiopia and other countries, they have modest resources, but you can see they are purposefully making progress in terms of improving the lots of their people. And so, again, the people-centered approach is key to health, but it's also key to many other aspects of our governance and development.
Thank you very much. That's a good place to hang it for today. Dr. Mohammed Ali Pate, CEO, Big Win Foundation, and former Minister of State for Health. Thank you very much for coming on Sunrise this morning. I mean, you gave us a wealth of information in that interview. Sunrise will be back in a short while with another interesting conversation. Stay with us.